Hello, it's BTP Liam here. We've just come up from Fenchurch Street Station at the Tower of London. We're starting our day off at the poppies outside the Tower of London that have been set up, as you can see here. And we're heading down to Big Ben soon for an inside tour around the inside of the building, which we're privileged to be able to experience. We're then heading down to the Imperial War Museum afterwards, and that is going to mark the start of Beyond the Points coverage of the World War I centenary.
Big Ben is one of the world's most iconic buildings, rating it as the 13th most iconic landmark in the world. The tower holds the largest four-faced chiming clock in the world and is the third tallest freestanding clock tower. In 2012, it was renamed as Elizabeth Tower from its original name, Clock Tower, to commemorate the Queen's Diamond Jubilee. However, it's known by everyone as Big Ben, which is in fact a reference to the biggest bell at the top of the tower. In 1834, the old Houses of Parliament were largely destroyed by a massive accidental fire. A new Parliament building was needed and was built in a neo-Gothic style. The tower is 315 feet high and we climbed up 334 steps to the top of the building. The clock is famous for its reliability, always being within a second of the time, although when the tower was first commissioned, this was a problem. The main bell, named Big Ben, is the largest of five bells, and the original bell was cracked by Denison during testing, so it was smashed up and recast. And when this recast bell was complete, it was pulled up to the centre of the tower by eight very strong men using their bare hands for a massive 18 hours. Big Ben is a symbol for London, like the red bus or black taxi. The sound of the clock chiming has also been used this way. Big Ben is a focus of New Year's celebrations and similarly on Remembrance Day for the start of the 2 minute silence. It could be heard within a staggering 5 mile radius, and when you look up at it, the gold decorations at the top, they're actually real. It's genuine 23 karat gold leaf paint, as fake paint would wear off more easily, so this is actually cheaper for the taxpayer.
BTP Joe here. We've just been inside Big Ben. Yes, indeed, that massive tower. We both got our ID pass on. It's an excellent tour. Very steep. It did seem a bit strange when all you're seeing is stairs going up and down, but nevertheless, it was a really good tower. And Big Ben rings or chimes 156 times a day. And we were up there from 2 until 3 o'clock, so we saw all of them chimes up there. And they were indeed very loud. We had earplugs on the very top. But you know, the view was excellent. It was a great time. It was right in the heart of London. And it's just been a great day. We're now off to the Imperial War Museum to see what bits they've got there.
Used by British troops.
and the ammunition would be made at places like Corriton and Wat Tyler, where we visited before in the past, and that's where they would make the ammo.